हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ गोकुल ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सिटी। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑफ क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स वी वेर डिस्कस परटर्बेशन थियरी विच इज वन ऑफ द अप्रोक्सीमेशन मेथड फॉर स्टेशनरी स्टेट। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अनदर अप्रोक्सीमेशन मेथड विच इज वेरिएशन मेथड। इन क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स द वेरिएशनल मेथड is one way of finding approximation to the lowest energy eigenstate or ground state and some excited states. The approximation method, variation method, allows calculating approximate wave functions of molecular orbital, and the basis for this method is the variational principle. So before we start the uses of variation method, discuss some basic concept regarding variational method. So first of all, equilibrium system. So in equilibrium system, the energy becomes minimum. The Hamiltonian is not observable. We know that the expectation value of H in state psi is given by break psi H cat psi is equal to W. If W, which is the expectation value of H, it is minimum or nearly falling towards minimum point, then our cat psi is little correct. If W is not minimum, we find new wave function in which W becomes W minimum, and that new function becomes trial wave function. So variation method consists of choosing a trial wave function which is depending on one or more parameters and finding the values of this parameter for which the expectation value of the energy is the lowest possible. So first of all, the question, prove that W is greater than or equal to 0. So the variation method is used primarily for the estimation of the ground state energy, and it is based on the fact that the lowest value, which is the expectation value of the Hamiltonian, can take ground state energy E0. So the expectation value of H in state psi is given by break psi H cat psi is equal to W. Now expanding cat psi as a linear combination of any orthogonal eigenfunction, here we take cat UK. So cat psi is equal to sigma CK UK. Now and complex conjugate of break psi is the complex conjugate of cat psi is break psi is equal to sigma L CL star UL. Now substituting equation 2 and 2a in equation number 1, so we get sigma CL star UL H sigma CK UK is equal to W. We can take CK outside, so sigma CL star CK break UL H UK is equal to W. Now the time independent Schrodinger equation is H UK is equal to EK UK. So we can put instead of H is equal to EK. Therefore above equation becomes sigma CL star CK break UL, instead of H we here put EK. So break UL EK cat UK is equal to W. We can take EK outside because it's not an operator. So sigma LK CL star CK EK break UL cat UK is equal to W. But break UL cat UK is equal to delta LK, which is the Kronecker delta, is equal to 1 when L is equal to K, and it is equal to 0 when L not equal to K, as we know. Now for K is equal to L, when L is equal to K, then equation number 3 becomes sigma K CK star CK EK UK cat UK is equal to W. Therefore W is equal to the value of break UK cat UK is equal to 1. So W is equal to CK star CK EK. So W is equal to sigma K CK square EK. But our wave function is normalized, and the normalization condition is break psi cat psi is equal to 1. Put the value of break psi and cat psi, so we get sigma CL star break UL cat CK star CK UK is equal to 1. Therefore, take CK outside, so sigma CL star CK break UL cat UK is equal to W. Therefore, sigma CL star CK, instead of break UL cat UK, we can put delta LK is equal to 1. So, for K is equal to L, delta LK is equal to 1. Therefore, sigma CK square is equal to 1. For K is equal to L, delta LK is equal to 1. So, we here put 1. Therefore, sigma CK square is equal to 1. Now, EK is greater than or equal to E0. Here, EK is any excited state energy and E0 is ground state energy. So, obviously, EK is greater than or equal to E0. Now, calculate it by 1. So, we get 1 dot EK greater than or equal to 1 dot E0. The value of 1 is sigma CK square. So, sigma CK square EK is greater than or equal to E0. Now, the value of sigma CK square EK is W from equation number 4. So, from equation 4 and 5, we have W is greater than or equal to E0, which is our required result. This equation shows that the lower the value of W, which is the expectation value of Hamiltonian H, the closer it is to E0. Therefore, we can try to minimize W by varying psi and take the minimum value of W as an estimate for the E0. Now, the variation method of psi is performed by first choosing for psi as a suitable function form depending on a number of parameter. We can take parameter as A1, A2 and AR. When this is done, we can vary the parameter and the value of W also varies. So, minimization of W is then accomplished by finding those values of A1, A2 and so on. Therefore, our next question is, so that under root h square minus w square is greater than or equal to w minus e0. First of all, calculating expectation value of h minus w square in psi state. So, we have break psi h minus w square cat psi is equal to expanding h minus w square. So, break psi h square minus 2hw plus w square cat psi is equal to break psi h square cat psi minus break psi minus 2 into 2hw cat psi plus break psi w square cat psi, which is equation number 6. Now, expanding cat psi as a linear combination of orthogonal eigenfunction of H. So, we get cat psi is equal to sigma CK cat UK, break psi is equal to CL star UL, and time independent Schrodinger equation is H UK is equal to EK cat UK. Now, the first term of equation number 6. The first term of equation number 6 is break psi H square cat psi. So, solve it. So, break psi h square cat psi is equal to the value of break psi and cat psi, sigma CL star break UL h square sigma CK cat UK. Take CK outside. So, sigma CL star CK break UL h square cat UK. Therefore, sigma CL star CK UL h into h cat UK. So, instead of H, we here put EK and take it outside. So, sigma CL star CK EK break UL H cat UK is equal to sigma CL star CK take EK outside. So, EK square UL cat UK. Now, second term of equation number 6 is minus psi 2hw cat psi. So let's solve it. So we can take 2w outside because it's a constant term. So 2w break psi h cat psi is equal to 2w. The value of break psi is CL star, break UL h. The value of cat psi is sigma CK cat UK. So 2w take CK outside. So 2w sigma CL star CK UL H UK. Take H outside as EK. So 2W sigma CL star CK EK UL UK, which is equation number 8. Now the third term of equation number 6 is break psi W square cat psi. So break psi W square cat psi is equal to, we can take W square outside because it's not an operator. So W square break psi cat psi is equal to W square, the value of break psi cat psi, sigma CL star UL sigma CK UK. So W square take CK outside, so CL star CK UL UK, which is equation number 9. Now put the value of equation number 7, equation number 8 and equation number 9 in equation number 6. So we get break psi H minus W square cat psi is equal to the value of equation number 6 sigma CL star CK EK square break UL cat UK minus the equation number 7 2W sigma CL star CK EK UL cat UK plus equation number 9 plus W square sigma CL star CK break UL cat UK. But U break UL cat UK is equal to delta LK, which is 1 for L is equal to K and 0 for L not equal to K. So deriving above equation for K is equal to L, so all the break UL cat UK is equal to 1 for L is equal to K. So we get break psi H minus W square cat psi is equal to CK square sigma CK square EK square, the value of UL UK is equal to 1 minus W sigma CK square EK plus W square sigma CK square. So we can take CK square common, so sigma CK square in bracket EK square minus 2W EK plus W square is equal to sigma k ck square in bracket ek minus w square. Now adding and subtracting w minus e square e0 square on above equation, so we get w minus e0 square plus sigma ck square ek minus w square minus w minus e0 square. Now the last term, this is the last term, the whole term is last term, is non-negative and which is provide the estimate W is closer to E0 than to any excited level EK. This condition must certainly be met if the estimate is to be considered any good at all. Once this is ensured, we have break psi H minus W square cat psi is greater than or equal to W minus E0 square. Therefore H square psi minus W square greater than or equal to W minus E0 square. Therefore H square, which is for the state psi minus W square in under root greater than or equal to W minus E0, which is our required results. Now the next question is trial function linear in variational parameters. So for that, we take the different state, which is cat xi 1, cat xi 2, cat xi n, which is the different state which are not orthogonal and not normalized. Now the linear combination of all such state are given as cat xi is equal to a1 cat xi 1 plus a2 cat xi 2 up to an cat xi n. Therefore cat psi is equal to sigma n a n cat xi n. Here a1, a2 up to an are the variational parameter. For the cat psi, we can take its complex conjugate as break psi is equal to sigma m am star break psi m. Using cat psi as a trial wave function, the expectation value of h is w is equal to break psi h cat psi is equal to the expectation value of h. If cat psi is normalized, then we have break psi cat psi is equal to 1. This is the normalization condition. Now we get minimum value of w by changing psi, and psi can be changed by changing all coefficient. So w is equal to phi break phi h cat psi upon 1 is equal to break psi h cat psi upon the value of 1 is break psi cat psi. So w is equal to the value of break psi and cat psi we are put. So we get w is equal to sigma m am star cat chi m h en an cat chi n upon, similarly for the denominator, sigma m am star chi m e sigma n an cat chi n. Therefore w is equal to, we can take an outside, so sigma m n am star an star break chi m h cat chi n. Similarly for the denominator, sigma m n am star an chi m cat chi n. Therefore we can take denominator right hand side, so w sigma am star an break chi m cat chi n is equal to sigma am star an break chi m h cat chi n. So now to get w is equal to w minimum, we have to differentiate above equation by am star. So first of all, dw upon d am star, and it is constant, so we here put constant, the rule of multiplication, plus w, we can take w constant, and the differentiation of this with respect to am star, we have the value sigma mn an chi m cat chi n is equal to sigma mn, the differentiation of this value with respect to am star, we have the value sigma mn an break chi m h cat chi n. For w is equal to w minimum, the value of dw upon dm star is equal to 0. Therefore this value is 0, so w sigma an chi m cat chi n is equal to sigma an break chi m h cat chi n. Let we take m cat chi m cat chi n is equal to delta m n, and break chi m h cat chi n is equal to h m n. Therefore sigma m n an h m n minus w delta m n is equal to 0. Here instead of chi m chi n, we here put delta m n, and instead of break chi m h cat chi n is equal to h m n, and take the right hand side term into the left hand side term, so we get sigma m n a n h m n minus w delta m n is equal to 0. Now the above equation can be written in an explicitly manner. So we obtain, for m is equal to 1, here we put m is equal to 1 and n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. So m is equal to 1, it becomes a1 h 1 1 minus w delta 1 1. So a1 h 1 1 minus w delta 1 1 plus a2 h 1 2 minus w delta 1 2, and so on an h1 n minus w delta 1 n. Similarly, for m is equal to 2 and m is equal to 3 and so on. For m is equal to m, we get a1 h m1 minus w delta m1 plus a2 h m2 minus w delta m2 minus plus so on and an in bracket h m n minus w delta m n. So these all are simultaneous equation for non-trivial solution we get from equation the determinant is equal to 0. Therefore, above equation can be written in matrix form as shown below. So we write the above equation as in matrix form like this. H11 minus W delta 1, H12 minus W delta 1 2 and so on. H1n minus W delta 1n. And similarly for in second matrix A1, A2 and so on An is equal to 0. The next topic is the hydrogen molecule. So now we shall make an estimate of the ground state energy of hydrogen molecule. For that, we here assuming the two nuclei A and B for two hydrogen atom. Here, it is a nucleus A for first hydrogen and it is a nucleus B for the second hydrogen. And here electron 1 and electron 2. The distance between nucleus A and electron 1 is R1A, nucleus A and nucleus B is capital R, electron 2 and nucleus B is R2B and electron 1 and electron 2 is R12. Similarly, for nucleus A and electron 2 is R2A and for electron 1 and nucleus B is R1B. Here we consider two possibilities. The first possibility is nucleus A and electron 1 and B2, that means nucleus B and electron 2. Similarly, second possibility is A2, nucleus A and electron 2 and nucleus B and electron 1. For first possibility, the Hamiltonian is H is equal to minus h cut square by 2m nabla 1 square minus z square upon r1a minus h cut square by 2m nabla 2 square minus z square upon r2b minus z square upon r1b minus z square upon r2a plus e square upon r12 plus e square upon capital R. So for hydrogen, we know z is equal to 1. So h is equal to minus h cut square by 2m nabla 1 square minus e square upon r1a plus similarly minus h cut square by 2m nabla 2 square minus e square upon r2b plus e square upon r1b minus e square upon r2a plus e square upon r12 plus e square upon capital R. Here this term is Hamiltonian and this is the interaction term of two electron. So this is the potential energy. So capital H, that means Hamiltonian, is equal to H1 plus V1. Now the total wave function for such system is equal U1 is equal to UA1 plus UB2. So UA1 is equal to 1 upon under root pi 1 upon A raised to 3 by 2 exponential minus R1A upon A. UB2 is equal to 1 upon under root pi 1 upon a raised to 3 by 2 exponential minus r2b upon small a. Now the Schrodinger equation is given by hu1 is equal to eu1. So now e is equal to 2e1. So e is equal to the value of e1 is equal to minus e square upon 2a. So capital E is equal to minus e square upon a. Similarly, for second possibility, the Hamiltonian is write down in similar way. H is equal to minus h cut square by 2m nabla 1 square minus z square upon r2a. Instead of r1a, here we put r2a, and instead of r2b, here we put आर वन बी। सो माइनस एच कर स्क्वायर बाय टू एम नेबला वन स्क्वायर माइनस जेड स्क्वायर अपॉन आर टू ए माइनस एच कर स्क्वायर बाय टू एम नेबला टू स्क्वायर माइनस जेड स्क्वायर अपॉन आर वन बी माइनस जेड स्क्वायर अपॉन आर वन ए माइनस जेड स्क्वायर अपॉन आर टू बी प्लस ई स्क्वायर अपॉन आर वन टू प्लस ई स्क्वायर अपॉन कैपिटल आर। टाउ टू वी रिलेबल एक्स टू एज एक्स वन एंड वाइस वर्सा। द वैल्यू ऑफ द इंटीग्रल इज नॉट अल्टर्ड सिंस दीज आर मेरली डमी वेरिएबल ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन। हाउ एवर अंडर दिस रिलेबलिंग यू वन बिकम्स यू टू एंड यू टू बिकम्स यू वन एंड एच रिमेन अनचेंज्ड। देयर फॉर एच वन वन इज इक्वल टू इन इंटीग्रेशन यू टू एच यू टू डी टाउ टू डी टाउ वन इज इक्वल टू एच टू टू। Therefore, in equation 1, we here put h11 is equal to h22. So now, the other relation in 1b follows in a similar fashion, not that delta 11 is equal to u1 square delta tau 1, d tau 1 d tau 2 is equal to in integration ua1 square d tau 1 in integration ub2 square d tau 2 is equal to 1. Similarly, for delta 1 2, u1 u2 d tau 1 d tau 2 is equal to ua1 ub2 ua2 ub1 d tau 1 d tau 2 is equal to s square, where s is equal to in integration uax ubx d tau. So, what remain to be done is to evaluate h11. We here know that h11 is equal to h22, similarly h12 is equal to h21, and delta 11 and delta 22 is equal to 1 and delta 12 is equal to delta 21. So now the remaining to be done is to evaluate h11, h21 and s, and hence determine es and ea, which is associated with the symmetric antisymmetric wave function psi s and psi a. So the lower of this would be our estimate for the ground state energy of the molecule. Now we can write h11 is equal to u in integration u1 in bracket h1 plus v1 u1 d tau 1 d tau 2 is equal to u1. Here h1 is equal to 2e, so u1 2e plus v1 u1 d tau 1 d tau 2 is equal to 2e plus k, where k is equal to in integration eua1 square eub2 square in bracket 1 upon r1b minus 1 upon r2a plus 1 upon r12 plus 1 upon capital R d tau 1 d tau 2. Similarly, so the value of h11 h22 is equal to 2e plus k. Similarly, for h21, integration u2 h1 plus v1 u1 d tau 1 d tau 2 is equal to in integration u2 2e plus v1 u1 d tau 1 d tau 2 is equal to 2 es square plus j. Here j is equal to in integration e square ua1 ub1 e square ub1 ub2 in bracket 1 upon r1b minus 1 upon r2a plus 1 upon r12 plus 1 upon r d tau 1 d tau 2. Therefore, we have two values of ES and EA. The value of ES is equal to 2E plus K plus J upon 1 plus S square, and EA is equal to 2E plus K minus J upon 1 minus S square. So the integral K, J and S can be evaluated exactly, but the expression are cumbersome. So involving various transcendental functional, and we do not present them here. So this is the variation method, which is one of the most useful approximation method. In next lecture, we will discuss another approximation method, which is WKB approximation. Thank you.